In this week's parsha, Parsha's Balak, we are introduced to Bilam, Bilam HaRasha. And Rashi brings a famous chazal that Bilam HaRasha was sort of given to the nations of the world as a response to a taina, to a claim that the nations had against HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And they said, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you have this love affair going with Klal Yisrael and Moshe Rabbeinu, and they seem to find favor in your eyes. That's not fair. You gave them Moshe Rabbeinu, of course, you're going to have a wonderful nation. If you gave us leadership of that stature, you gave us our own Navi to be our guide and our eyes, then we would also be great. So why are you only choosing them, and what about us? Why are we, in a sense, playing second fiddle? So Rashi brings that, therefore HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, fine, you want a Navi, I'll bring you a Navi. I'll bring you a Navi even greater than the level of Moshe Rabbeinu, and let's see what happens. And they get Bilam, and the rest is history. So the question that sort of comes out immediately at you is, what kind of response does HaKadosh Baruch Hu give to the nations of the world? if they're claiming that if you give us a leader like Moshe Rabbeinu, we would be great. You give them a Bilam? Give them a Bilam HaRasha? Bilam HaRasha, who is, in a sense, outdone and outclassed by a donkey? This is the kind of Navi you give them? I mean, the nation should have a wonderful taina back that, hello, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we wanted somebody of Moshe Rabbeinu's stature. What are you giving us to Bilam HaRasha? So, I once saw a fantastic answer to this question by saying that, let's really understand the claim of the nations of the world. If the Umus Olam, if the nations of the world were saying that we want you to love us as well, and we want to have a leader like Moshe Rabbeinu, well, if that's the essence of their claim, what kind of claim is that? You want Moshe Rabbeinu as your leader? Convert, and you'll have Moshe Rabbeinu as your leader. What's the problem? Become a member of Klal Yisrael. We have a process called Geirus. You can convert, and you'd have a wonderful opportunity to be as loved as every member of Klal Yisrael is loved by HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And you'd have Moshe Rabbeinu as your leader. So just come and convert. Clearly, that was not their point. That was not their message. That was not their claim against HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Their claim was a different claim, and in a sense, a deeper claim, and a more, maybe more relevant claim. And that was that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you offered us the Torah. We rejected the Torah because of the rules that were in the Torah. But we feel that there is another way of reaching Shlemus. We feel that through the intellect, through a person's mastery of their own conditions, without the, in a sense, the crutch of the Torah, one can reach a deep connection to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So they weren't asking to replace, to be given a Navi like Moshe Rabbeinu. If they wanted Moshe, somebody like Moshe, they can have Moshe. They could become part of the Jewish people. But they were really saying that we from our mind, from our intellectual perspective, are able to become dominant spiritual beings without the Torah. We don't need the Torah. The Torah is in a sense like a crutch. And if you gave us a great intellectual, a luminary, somebody whose intellect dominates the world, then we will show you, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that we can achieve greatness. And we can sort of reach that connection to you without the necessities of all the 613 commandments that the Jewish people require. To which HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, aha, so that's what you're saying. You believe like the Greeks and like maybe the Romans that the human intellect can reach, can get one to a level of completeness and shlemus and connection that is maybe even superior to what the Jewish people have. Let's see. I will give you somebody of the most superior intellect that the world knows. And let's see what happens. Let's see how that works out for you. And therefore, he gave him Bilam. And that's what the Chazal mean, that Bilam was at a higher level. His intellect, his ability to understand and to perceive things, apparently was even on a higher level. But what Bilam did not have, and what the Goyim did not want, is Torah. We wanted to do it, say the Goyim, without the Torah. We don't need the Torah. The Torah, we have a Torah in the world, and we want Judaism, we'll become Jews. But we want to do it without it. To which HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, you people are very foolish. You don't really understand. I'm the one who made you. I'm the one who hardwired you, and I know what you need. And you can't achieve that connection without Torah. You can't achieve that relationship with me without following my guidelines and my ground rules. And you need to buy into this system because this is the only system that works. It's the only system that allows an individual to reach the true pinnacle of human perfection. And if you try any other which way, it will fall short because you don't have that sort of the fuel, the energy, the spiritual energy to make it happen. And that spiritual energy, of course, is Torah. So certainly what Bilam proved was exactly what HaKadosh Baruch Hu was saying to the nations. I'll give you what you want. Intellect is what you want. You'll get intellect. But intellect will not take you to the, so to speak, promised land. And sure enough, Bilam fell uniquely short. And his, similar to the philosopher who was once followed home by his disciple, and when he followed him home and he saw what he did in the house, he was shocked by the debased activities of what this philosopher, this famous philosopher, was involved in. And to which the student says, my teacher, my leader, what are you doing? And he says, he answered back the famous answer, do what I say, don't do what I do. That if you don't have the Torah as your fuel, as your anchor, you might have great insights, but you will fall short because you will not be able to really maintain that high level of what you perceive to be the right conduct in a consistent fashion. It will fall really desperately and astonishingly short of the goal. And that's what Bilam did. He ended up becoming very debased. He ended up involved in the lewdest types of activities, and he ended up dying on a sword in a very, very low fashion. So we need to take this message very much to our hearts. There are no other ways. There is no other path to connection to Kodesh Baruch Hu. We need to reinforce that concept in our own hearts. The only way to reach Shleimus, the only way to reach connection and perfection and closeness to Kodesh Baruch Hu is through our commitment to Torah, our observance of the mitzvahs, of following the ways of our Chazal in illuminating the path towards Veikus B'Hashem. But Hashem, we should be successful in that endeavor, and in that tzchus, B'Hashem, B'Zochah, to be a Mashiach, Mehir Yameinu.